हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल बी टॉपर विद मी। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट इज मैटर अराउंड अस प्योर, क्लास 9 केमिस्ट्री, सेकंड चैप्टर।
लेट अस गेट स्टार्टेड। सो फर्स्ट, एज यू कैन सी द चैप्टर नेम इटसेल्फ आस्क्स अ क्वेश्चन व्हिच इज मैटर अराउंड अस प्योर। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस रिकॉल अवर टॉपिक दैट व्हाट इज मैटर। मैटर इज नथिंग बट द सब्सटेंस व्हिच ऑक्यूपाइज स्पेस हैव मास is known as matter. This topic, if you want to understand more better, then you can see my previous video. I made a video on what is matter and all about first chapter. So as we now understood what is the meaning of matter, the matter is subdivided into two parts, which is pure substance and impure substance. Now pure substance, first we take a look at that, then it is made up of only one component. Pure substance is made up of only one component. Okay? Pure substance is made up of only one component. Okay? And pure substance is also further divided into two parts, which is elements and compounds. Elements are nothing but the substance made up of only one kind of atoms. Only one kind of molecule. Right? Is atom, elements. And compounds are nothing but made up of more than one kind of elements. Okay? Elements made up of only one kind and compounds made up of more than one kind. We'll understand everything in deep in the further chapter. Then we'll talk about impure substance. Now impure substance is nothing but substance in which there are more than one type of atom or molecules made up of more than one kind of element. Is known as impure substance. Impure substance is further divided into homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture. Homogeneous means throughout same. Composition is throughout same in homogeneous, and in heterogeneous the composition is different. So you need to remember these point very clearly, that in homogeneous composition is same, constant, and in heterogeneous the composition is not same, it is different. Right? So now I hope that you at least understood this much graph. From here, this is something where you need to clear all your topics. Now we'll move further to pure substance. We'll learn more about pure substance. We'll learn properly about pure substance now. A pure substance is one that has uniform composition and always has same texture, color, taste at the given temperature and pressure. Now what this line says, this means that a pure substance is one that has uniform composition. Uniform composition means throughout same, and throughout same means homogeneous mixture. So pure substance, now from this line I can conclude that pure substance is homogeneous mixture. Why I said that? Because in the first line, as you can see, it is written that pure substance is one that has uniform composition, and as I explained you before, that homogeneous is one which has uniform composition. So you need to remember this point, that so pure substance is a homogeneous mixture. You need to remember this line very well, and always has same texture, color, taste. Pure substance always has same texture, always have same color and taste at the given temperature and pressure. Okay, now next line. It is not possible to change the composition of pure substance by any physical method. Now, we cannot separate any pure substance by physical methods. Physical method includes many, like we will understand everything in deep about separation methods too. For physical method, if now I'm giving few example, it is, we can say filtration, sublimation, all are that physical method from which pure substance cannot be separated. Now it has fixed boiling point and melting point. This is a very important line, that pure substance has fixed boiling point and melting point. Right? So I hope you understood what pure substance actually is. Let us recap this very fast. Pure substance is homogeneous in nature. Right? It always has same texture, color and taste. Right? It is not possible to change composition of pure substance by any physical method. In other words, we cannot separate pure substance by physical methods. and it has fixed boiling point and melting point. Now, as we seen before too, that pure substance is further divided into two parts. Here we can see once again that pure substance is further divided into two parts, which is elements and compounds. So now, everything about elements, including characteristics of element, classification of element, everything we will cover up in our next part. So till then, don't forget to subscribe my channel for the next part and press the notification bell to get notified whenever I post. Do give this video a big thumbs up and comment down if you have any doubt in today's lecture, whatever we understood. Also, you can comment down what type of explanation of topic you want next, which chapter you want next, or which chapter's notes you want next, or if under any type of video you want, then you can also comment. And don't forget to share this with all your friends who face difficulties in understanding these topics. Till then, stay safe.